Another look. Let's see how close, right on the button, Tommy Hearns reflexively falls back.
Hearns was launching left at the same time, but Hill's got there first and with the most power.
Going to have to test him downstairs and stop breaking him over the top. The man is busted up. Lay with that jab, okay?
You get in front of him, come and squat down. Hook right here, right on top, okay? Because every time you squat down, he just seen the jab. Squat down, hook right here.
Those last words were spoken by Billy Hearns, who is the brother of Thomas. He's now working in the corner. The chief second and trainer, however, is Alex Shearer, who was in the ring with him.
Hill is beginning to show signs of this tough jab. Not only is it swelling, but it's swelling in the both eyes. And no marks on Tommy. Tommy's legs have not carried him forward like they should with this jab. He's sort of just a statue standing in front of him. His back leg is not giving him the propulsion that he usually has. And it caved in on him in the corner, which looks clean. Doesn't look like it has any water. First movement from Virgil Hill.
And he was going side to side, and Hearns was trying to cut him off, and trying to keep him from coming back out the center ring to finally work it. Nice jabs by Thomas Hearns. Two of them, Ferdy, put them together. Hard jabs.
And if his legs will just carry him forward with that, and he comes in with that right hand, he's going to be right where he wants Hill at the end of his jab.
Again, Thomas has been yet to drop the bomb on Virgil Hill. Done a good job with his left jab. No knockdowns in the fight. We are in round number six. Comes with the right hand, but Hill managed to move inside of that punch, and it went behind him harmlessly.
This is a fencing match. Set of swords are using left jabs. I mean, Tommy's trying to bust up his face with a left jab, hoping to follow with a right, but it seems that that's his strategy. Just use that left hand. This round, it's been working very well for Tommy Hearns.
In round five, Virgil Hill was effective. He opened up a little bit more offensively, but he has not followed up that momentum here into round six.
Could well be that Tommy's offensive is starting to put some doubts in Virgil's mind.
And now we see a slight suspicion of blood from the left nostril there for Virgil Hill.
Oh.
Right uppercut that caught Virgil Hill on the inside, and a follow-up right by Thomas Hearns. Thomas on the attack really for the first time tonight.
And bombs are landing on Virgil Hill, and Hill smiled back. Uppercuts, right hand.
Here comes the hitman. Virgil Hill smiling at him, nodding at him.
That's not good news anywhere.
Now Hill trying to answer back with something other than a smile. Right hand again by Thomas Hearns.
Well, you're not going to take too much of that. He better start doing something else.
Left hook from Hearns. Thomas really mixed it up well in that round. He mixed up his attack.
Big round. Big round for Tommy Hearns.
Now you're letting him get too much momentum going. You're waiting on him too much. You gotta be forcing your jab. You hear me? Double and triple your jab up. Be forcing it. Don't wait on this guy. Don't you hear your face and jab? You hear me? Go to work out
there. And here is the Hearns barrage. Watch the succession of punches. He held his head, hit him with an uppercut. Now he's belaboring his body, and these shots are landing, and with great effect, even though Hill is smiling. That's one of those, it doesn't hurt, but it really does. Now you see, that's almost a foul. You can't hold his head and hit him like that. But two resounding body shots. He came back with a series of spectacular shots, which should have at least put him down, but he didn't.
And that right uppercut started it all as we go into round seven, but there was obvious concern in the corner by Freddie Roach of Virgil Hill.
Oh, he should have. He said, don't let him get started. Don't let him get brave. Well, I mean, it's very easy to say, but it's because Tommy was having his way.
He said, you're letting Hearns get too much momentum. So Hill, let's see if he tries to offset that now and get something again going himself offensively. But that was a Thomas Hearns round in the sixth.
Oh, it was a big one. Now, comes Virgil Hill's time in offense, and this is when he can get careless. Obviously, his corner's charged and will come back and take around. Virgil's trying to go back on the offensive, but now he's facing the Hearns, who's tasted blood. He's tasted what he wanted to, solid shots.
Only the last left really landed, and that was up high on the head in that four-punch combination by Hill.
Tommy playing with him a little bit, letting him get brave, trying to lure him into another one of those punch-outs.
Woo! It's beginning to find its mark. He's measuring him with the left and then throwing the right.
And you can't go on all night. You can't let Tommy Hearns hit you with the right hand all night long. Nobody can take that. And if he ever uncorks the left hook after the right hand, then you've got major trouble on your hands if you're Virgil Hill. Again, Virgil Hill right in front of the cannon.
Hill trying a left hook to the body. We haven't seen that from Hearns. You know, late in Hearns' career, he really developed a fine left hook to the body from long range. He used it to really blast out James Shuler. And of course, he was really blasting Iran Barkley with that left hook to the body until he got knocked out himself.
Sweeping hooks to the body were blocked by the arms of Tommy Hearns. Surprising that he didn't come in inside those hooks and land a straight right hand. They were open. He was open.
Hearns, at least so far in this round, has not pressed the big advantage that he had in the last round.
Yeah, he's let the momentum slide again. Just what it seemed like this momentum of the champ. Again, a good right hand. And a better left hook to the body by Tommy Hearns. A good hook to the head by Tommy Hearns.
Virgil Hill just has not shown anything to really bother Thomas Hearns in the way of power so far.
And twice, Hearns has hooked him behind the head with his glove and hit him with his right hand. And Mills has not warned him yet. Not seen it.
Well, we are through seven rounds of a fight that has been very interesting. Only one real decisive round between the two. Here's Alex Shearer now with Tommy Hearns.
Big breath. Take a deep breath. Okay, look. Listen to me close. Second win. Deep breath. Take a deep.
There's a kind of right hand by Hearns that has put away many an opponent. And what seems to be impressive to me is Hill's taking them very well. He's taking these shots very well and not showing anything except that his face is breaking up. Let's take another look at it if we can. And apparently we can.
Keep your hands up. Listen to me.
I'm the surprise.
Double stick.
Let's listen a moment.
You break to the body. Okay? Don't be blowing your nose out. Don't let you get back here. You're going to be hit with the right hand, okay? Time to keep them hands up and you go home, baby. Keep them hands up and you go home. Now keep them hands up. Keep that right hand on chin.
The scoreboard and Hill slightly 67-66 ahead. Although if you're just walking in and not keeping score, you would have to say that Tommy, based on that big, big round that he had in the sixth, had turned the fight and was starting to go right down victory trail. Hill came out. He is an undefeated champion, a man who does not know defeat, and took the next round.
Well, Hill has yet to show that he can hurt Thomas Hearns.
You know, the whole rap on Tommy is he's been hurt by all the several fights that hit him on the jaw in the last two or three outings in the last two or three years, actually. And yet, he has taken everything that Hill has thrown. He's landed solidly, and it hasn't bothered Tommy at all. Well, he's trained 6 months, he said. Sometimes that's disastrous for an old fighter, but right now, it looks like it's paid off.
Hill still trying to see if he can back up Hearns, if possible, with the jab. Hearns again trying to shake out, lowers his arms to his side, shakes them both. There it is again.
He does that a lot, though. At first I thought his arms get tired. He's doing that. His muscle got tired. He's done that all his career when he was a young man. Sort of an affectation of this. Oh, good nice hook.
Short, compact hook by Thomas Hearns to the head.
Boy, that's the kind that snaps you back. Makes you pay attention. Again, action is slowed up. Tommy just trying to pick his shot.
Virgil's right hand has been a total non-entity tonight. He's trying to beat Thomas Hearns. He's almost a one-handed fighter, and there's the left jab from Hearns right back.
But he's always done that. He's always been a left-handed fighter. Oh, another right hand over the jab. Very well by Thomas.
Well, you can do that to defeat the likes of Mike Peek, but I mean, you know, I don't know if that's enough to beat a Thomas Hearns.
Well, he better start throwing pretty soon. Tommy seems to take alternate rounds. I mean, he takes one, he gives one, he takes one. Now he's fighting well again. Looks like he just needs a little opening, and he's going to be back into that combination style. There it is. Three, four straight, good, hard jab. He got hit a jab, but not as hard as he threw.
Yeah, he jarred the head of Virgil Hill on that triple jab.
He may have to stop this and tape up the gloves of Virgil Hill. His tape is coming off.
Well, right, that was not a good punch thrown by Thomas Hearns.
But he didn't pay for it like he should have. I mean, you know, as quick a hands as Hill has, when he reaches with a right hand like that, he should have really got kicked for it.
He should have had an opportunity to exploit it. I think it was there.
Yeah, it was there. He's fighting cautious. You know, he's not
free. Time, time. Come here.
All right, here's what you talked about, Ferdy. They've called time here now. They'll just cut that tape out. Final few seconds of the round. Virgil Hill back to the corner, and Freddie Roach again immediately with him.
All right, Virgil. You're letting this fight get away from you, hear me? You gotta pick it up. You gotta fight this guy right now, okay? Combination, let's go after this sucker, right? Hear me? Where's your ball in the fight? Pick it up. Okay.
Let's look at these hard right hands, left hands. Let's look at the left hand that he throws. Hook right there. That's a perfect hook. That's just what he does so well. And now, coming back the other way, look at the master boxer. One, two, and three jabs. Now, that is nice boxing on the part of Virgil Hill. The difference was in the power. Hill was scoring points like with a fencing sword, and Hearns was hitting with a mallet.
When you jab, hold off, brother. Go reverse it, okay? When you jab, hold off, keep it back there.
Yeah, they're firing a lot of information at Tommy Hearns in the corner, but the biggest information I thought and the most significant was what Freddie Roach said to Virgil Hill between rounds. Freddie said, "You're letting this fight get away from you."
Yeah, and the same thing could be said to Tommy. He's giving alternate rounds away. I mean, every once in a while, it comes out, he takes a round very, very big, and then he just rests the next round. He's got to put two or three together. He's got to give Hill the idea that it's desperation time. There you go.
Combination of three punches with the left hand, body and head.
And again, nothing with the right. Nothing that lands. So often in his career, Tommy has come in as a wanted, heavy piece of artillery and turns into a boxer. Tonight, he's boxing again.
Well, he has seemed to take delight because so many people, his reputation has always been as a slugger and a guy with a big shot, but he is taking delight when he's been able to outbox boxers. Most of these punches in a rather wild exchange missed.
Oh.
Good solid right by Thomas Hearns, and Virgil Hill felt that one, but he took it pretty well.
There's another hook. That was a left and a right and a hook and another right right now. And a left behind it.
There
and
comes
a hook
Hearns.
Behind it.
He's starting to land some big bombs, and Virgil Hill standing there did not wobble.
What? Virgil went two inches off the canvas with that right hand.
Hearns coming on strong.
What a chin on Virgil Hill.
We are in round nine, and Thomas Hearns is enjoying a good round, solid round for the hitman.
What a hit.
To the left and the right hand by Hearns, and Hill is in some difficulty here. Throwing some little pity-pat punches in close, but he's going to need more than that to keep Thomas off.
I'm surprised Tommy didn't come in with a finisher there, because Hill is waving in the wind. He's certainly not got anything on his punches. He can come right through him if he wants to.
Virgil Hill has only been down once as a pro. That was against Bobby Chez.
Well, I don't know what reach out and hit him with to put him down, because this man can punch, Tommy Hearns. It's the last thing that goes in the fight of the puncher. And he has hit him a shot that would have put anybody out.
Hill trying to get something going with the left hand again.
Tommy should take advantage of Hill trying to make up for lost time, for lost points here. He should invite him to come in. There you go.
Right hand a little bit low. Those landings on the other side, though, was blocked from that. That cut by Hearns to the body.
Those are power blows. That's Hearns' power blow when he turns it down like that.
Very good round, the ninth for Thomas Hearns.
Another excellent round, like the sixth.
Get it? I was wondering, you're going to think it'd be more than that. You've got to keep this guy going back. Did you hear me? This guy's dead tired. You fight for 3 minutes, he's finished. Okay. Back him up with your jab and throw your combination, Virgil. You got to pick it up.
Let's look at this bombing right hand. Watch, the left hand comes in first, then the right. And look at the little dance that Hill does. Whoa. Now watch the left hand first, sets it up. Whang, right there. Look at the little dance that he does. And a hook behind it. That should have put Virgil Hill out. But he didn't. He's still here. Still in this fight.
And now for the first time tonight, we hear the chant of Tommy. Tommy, how do you have it scored, Ferdy?
Well, so far, Hearns is ahead 86-85 down the bases that last big round. And it remains to see what how the judges treated those two big rounds, because they were big and they did wobble Virgil Hill.
Well, Thomas Hearns is the guy coming on strong, and there was clearly a sense of desperation in the message that Freddie Roach was giving to Virgil Hill in the corner. And now underneath the left eye, we see the first bruising as well for Virgil Hill. He's already badly bruised under the right eye, but now we see it coming out under the left eye as well.
Tommy just playing, doing a little showboating. He really doesn't need that. He needs to get back into business here. He's not that far ahead. He is, however, the momentum is in his favor. Everything is in his favor. Virgil Hill is starting to fight a desperation fight, as his corners told him. This is slipping away. Tommy can't afford to be so patient that he gives away rounds, and he certainly doesn't look like it there. He's double and triple jabbing.
I think the biggest shock perhaps to Virgil Hill is that Thomas can jab with him. And his jab has been as fast and much harder than Virgil Hill.
Biggest shock to me is that Virgil Hill hasn't moved around. I mean, I just don't understand a guy that got here by playing Pony Express can all of a sudden stand in front of a cannon and challenge him to get hit and get hit. Nothing in the punches of Virgil Hill.
He got no body behind him at all. He is landing some arm punches with that left, but Hearns hardly bothered by him.
No, and he's waiting too long. He's letting points be built up by Hill with nothing punches. He's just giving him a bonus. Pretty soon that right hand will follow the jab. Tom setting up the right hand.
Has yet to throw it in this round. Virgil Hill picking up some steam with his own jab this round.
Because Tommy's letting him.
Is Hearns taking this round off, Ferdy?
He certainly looks like it here. Almost after where the momentum has totally changed. Low blow. Low blow. Mills on the wrong side of that. Virgil Hill landed a low blow. Tommy didn't like it, but not that bad. Puzzling how Tommy Hearns, with such an advantage, is dominating almost when he wants to fight. He's dominating Hill and letting him come back into the round, even though he hasn't got any strength or danger.
It was in time.
They're taking the mouthpiece back to get it washed off after the mouthpiece came out.
Let's go, come on. Here we go, time in.
Looks a little tired.
Come on.
Now Nice jab by Hill. And the bell to end round 10, one in which Hearns really did not do much. But perhaps he was saving it up for a big finish, two rounds to go.
I don't understand giving away a round when you have so totally dominated the one before. It's so easy to pick up the next one.
We got to keep dogging it. You got to stay busy with both hands. Listen to me, man.
This is a man who has a storied career behind him, Thomas Hearns. Five world titles, five different weight classes. You take a look at the welterweight, which he won over Pepino Cuevas, the super welterweight when he beat Benitez, the light heavyweight title when he knocked off Dennis Andres, the WBC middleweight championship he won, and the WBO super middleweight crown. This is a man with a great history behind him. Could it be a sixth title is in the offing here tonight?
Well, it certainly looks like if Tommy has a lot of willpower, it's the 11th and 12th, the championship is his to be taken.
Hill trying the right, finally, after following with the left. Now Hill trying to be a little more active offensively. Perhaps he's testing the water here to see if Hearns is slowing down, if Hearns really didn't do a lot in that last round.
Well, I told him he's got to take these rounds, but they said the same thing in Hearns' corner. They said, you got to put the combination together, you're going to sleep. Now, whether he's tired or whether he can't get that old body to respond is another thing, but certainly with the advantage he had, he sure should have come ahead. So now he's got these two rounds. He blows these two, and he's blown a chance to win another victory. On the other hand, if he wins these two, it could very well be that he wins.
Good right hand by Virgil Hill as he back turns out of the corner. There was a good right before they got tangled up, and it was Virgil Hill who landed, and Hearns kind of slapped at him right back.
Sharper punching from Hearns again.
You know, I think that was the first clean right that Virgil Hill landed in this fight for him.
Yeah, it has. He has just not thrown it. See, he's not throwing anything there, and Tommy's blocking it all. Curious to see that Hearns has let the fire die.
Hearns appeared to be taking total command of the fight in round 9. Really had a big hook from Thomas.
Now that's a big hook. And comes back Hill with a good left and right.
Hill trying to fire back, looking for that long sought after respect. That was the theme of this fight, a battle for respect. Right hand by Thomas Hearns, wobbled Virgil Hill a little bit.
Another good shot to the body by Hearns, and now Hearns is building up these points. Good hook by Hearns.
Here comes Thomas again, he'll go to both the body and the head. He just missed with the right hand, follows it up with the left. Hearns misses. There it goes. There's the right hand by Thomas Hearns. Hill again in some difficulty.
Hill in difficulty. Sledgehammer blows by Tommy. Sledgehammer blows.
Hill trying to fire back. Does he have anything with which to hurt Thomas Hearns?
It's all macho on the part of Virgil Hill. He's just trying to show his heart, but that could be very dangerous instead of trying to hold on and tie up.
It's a big rally by Thomas Hearns. Hill is not wobbling and staggering. We're not trying to mislead you that way, but he was in some trouble. Now the champ, Tommy.
You could see his punches happen, I think, and you could see a look of desperation on his face. Another big round for Tommy Hearns.
Bell ends round 11.
Guys, stumbling around like that, you gotta finish this up there. You gotta knock this fucker out. Let's go now. You gotta get out there. You gotta go punching. Hey, die with this guy. Open up. You hear me? Both hands. You're in there doing nothing. Your hands are free. You get mean, Virgil. Come on. Fight this guy. You open up this.
That right hand that lands solidly would have put just about anybody away, and yet Virgil flails back almost reflexively because it's almost impossible to imagine why he didn't go down. Well, this fight's up for grabs. I have Tommy ahead, 105, 104. Tommy smiling.
Freddie Roach was pleading with Virgil Hill to let his fists go in this round. Absolute desperation coming from Freddie Roach. He's going, your hands are free, throw something.
I hope Tommy doesn't think this fight's in the bag and can rest this last round. He has had such bad luck in the fights that he's ahead and got caught, but it doesn't look like Virgil Hill's got anything to catch him with. Hill has no power left, and well, he shouldn't with the hammering blows that he's taken. One thing can be said, he's got a granite chin, has Virgil Hill.
I think Hearns has got to approach this 12th round with having a good round. Remember, 2 years ago, everybody thought he was miles ahead of Sugar Ray Leonard when they fought, and Hearns got caught in that last round, lost the last round, and ended up getting a draw in a fight that everyone thought he had won.
That must be going through his mind, but he has to know that he needs this last round. He has to know that in a close fight, it just may be the champion that takes it. So even though he's a legend, oh, here comes Tommy Hearns.
So much more on the punches of Hearns than Virgil Hill.
When Hearns' mind clicks into killer, boy, it is a different fighter that punches. And when he punches, they're so accurate and so effective that the points build up. It's going to be hard for Virgil Hill to retain his championship, but then again, we have seen stranger scores.
Hill trying to be more aggressive, trying to throw the right now. But in doing so, don't forget, he becomes a little more open for the Thomas Hearns bombs.
Wells Lane's done a very decent job of refereeing because you haven't seen him. And that's when you know the guy's doing well.
Hill coming forward finally with the right, throwing the jab. Less than a minute to go in this fight.
But getting hit as he does that. As soon as he comes in, Tommy's getting into attack mode. Oh, what a right hand by Tommy. Oh, another left hook right on the ear.
That right hand caught, Hill on the side of the head, still jarred him.
What a heart and what a chin has Virgil Hill. On the other hand, let's finally say it, the weakened chin of Tommy Hearns has nowhere been in evidence, and his legs are there tonight.
Well, I'll tell you this, Thomas Hearns is not a sharp fighter.
Well, not off tonight. He fought an undefeated, very tough fighter. In my book, he's winning this fight. This round is not over. It's been Hearns' destiny.
Here comes Thomas again, two right hands.
He's mauling, and he's beating him up, and now let's let it play to the finish.
Has ascended to a world title for the sixth time. The judges will decide that, however.
If you just walked in the room and saw this fight, you have to say that Tommy dominated the fight and convincingly proved to be a better boxer, did more damage with his punches, and should have won it point by point. I got it 115, 113. May well be that he won it by more, and it also, since we have seen some strange decisions, may be that Virgil Hill is soon see. Don't go away.
Well, of course, if you listen to Freddie Roach in that corner and the sense of desperation that was in his voice as he was pleading with Virgil Hill to throw more going into that last round. And Virgil did try in that last round to throw more punches, to be more aggressive. And I thought he was, for the first time really in the fight, beginning to take it a little to Thomas Hearns. But there was no question that the difference in the strength of the two punches was so evident, as Thomas Hearns just had more power, I thought, than Virgil Hill. But we have to wait for the official decision to find out who won this fight, and to tell us, it's Jimmy Lennon Jr.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 12 outstanding championship rounds of boxing, we have a unanimous decision, and here are the score totals. Judging ringside, Chuck Giampa scores the bout 116-112. Jerry Roth and Art Lurie, they both agree. They both score the bout 115-113. All three in favor of the winner and the new light heavyweight champion of the world, Thomas Hitman.